welcome to the end of the world, boys!
This skull could have popped our tires. You want to explain that to Dylan?
Shit, man, you worry too much. Nothing happened.
Sick the other day to go to the Wing Bowl. Bunch of fat shits eating chicken wings in front of 20,000 people. I mean, who wouldn't want to see that? Do you know how many other gym teachers called out with me? All of them. We teach gym, for Christ's sake, so we miss a Friday, and what? The kids don't learn how to run in a circle? I was the only one dumb enough to make the paper. Here, look at that. You don't want to look?
Driving.
It's awesome. So that's why I gotta do this ridiculous field trip with the BD kids. Some team building bullshit out in the middle of Lake Serial Killer.
BD?
Behavioral disturbed normal intelligence, but... Fuck my sack! They weren't supposed to be left out there alone! Whoa! 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 What in the F are you two a-holes doing?
You called me a faggot.
Are you?
Hope not.
No one asked you, Mary Jane Watson Parker.
My ankle!
Did I say hello? You're scaring Rain Man.
We have actual names, you know.
Oh, I'm sure you do, Wednesday Adams. And I'll learn them when you all learn to calm the F down. And you, don't go call people that word, okay, Judd Hirsch? It's a bad word. Just say homo or something.
Oh, you mean Judd Nelson? From the Breakfast Club. I'm sorry, it's just hard to keep track of your outdated references.
I don't know what I mean. All I know is I gotta babysit you dummies for the rest of the day. And I don't want any more fighting, or cutting, or naked cell phone pictures, or whatever the hell else you do.
Gotta protect my egg. The class.
Right, okay. So are we clear? Are we clear?
Yes.
So get on the GD bus! Okay, the place we're gonna be going to is Lake Indian name. You guys are gonna be doing some team building exercise.
Really, we're gonna be a team? Oh, I'm excited. Can I be team captain?
Yeah, you could be team, shut up!
That doesn't make any sense.
Anyways, it's 2 hours to this place. Stay in your seats and don't make any trouble. Let's all get through this with minimum of bleeding, okay? That's the spirit.
Probably not. I think I'm the funniest guy in the world. So, a little funny girl, right?
She needs to learn to respect herself.
She respects her tits. That's a start.
You're being an ass.
She probably respects that about herself, too. I'm just mad I didn't get a picture.
I got one.
Psst.
horse.
What a shame.
You're looking for dignity and self-respect. You're not gonna find it that way.
No one asked you, dude.
Yeah, no one asked you to. Fucks me so goddamn obvious.
Quiet down back there. I'm trying to get some work done. Mike, you can't keep your eyes on the road? Let's maintain solidarity. Okay, we're gonna go outside and see what happened. If any of you retards fight again, I swear on the soul of my dead hamster that I will set this bus on fire and start a new life for myself in Mexico. For the love of God, stop picking that sound! Put those away!
Girl's got her own airbags. What'd we hit? Christ, looks like a fucking dinosaur.
Tire's destroyed. We're gonna have to call for a tow truck.
Tow truck? Fuck me in the asshole.
Son of a bitch! This day couldn't get any worse. Tell me you have service.
I don't have a cell.
If 1972 ever comes back, you'll be well prepared. Come on out, you animals!
How far from civilization are we?
Depends on your definition of civilization.
Okay, listen up. Nothing to worry about. But if none of you have cell phone coverage, we're all stuck here forever.
Yeah, me too.
Not a single GD one of you. Typical.
What do you think? Anybody home in the base motel?
Are you kidding me? Ain't no phone in there. Maybe a telegram.
Hey, zip it. Trying to forget that this is all your fault we're here.
My fault?
All of you.
I was just protecting my egg.
Gooch, that's some horror movie shit, man. It's guaranteed there's an axe murderer in there.
Good. Maybe he'll have a cell phone. Hello? Anybody home? Motorist in distress. Success!
Yay! We're gonna live!
And you, go upstairs and find something here that can, you know, fix that.
They don't look broken to me, sir.
Oh, yuck.
You're skating on pretty thin water. And I know I said that wrong. Don't say another GD word. You, find something to cover yourself.
But it'll be all scary upstairs alone.
You, go with her.
Me?
Yeah, you, go with her.
Really? You're letting the two of them go upstairs together?
Sit there with your boyfriend there and play the quiet game.
He's not my boyfriend.
You're losing!
What should I do?
Just stand there and be weird. Great job. Now, let's call for a tow truck and end this effing nightmare.
On that thing? Oh, wait, that works.
Oh, it's gonna work. I said three Hail Marys. God doesn't hate me enough to leave me here with you people.
Well, I guess he is.
Crisis of faith.
I'm not talking to you.
What? Why not?
I guess someone's gonna have to walk down the road to find some help.
There are people in that garage.
How do you know that?
Truck prints. Fresh stuff's on the doors and the floor. Okay, Sherlock, bus driver. That's great! This place isn't abandoned.
I don't think it's great. You need to gather the students out front as quickly as possible. We're getting out of here.
Wait, what?
Oh my god. These clothes are like from the Dark Ages or something.
They remind my foster parents. Clothes are like a million years old, but they never have money in their pockets.
Okay. Found it.
What do you think?
I don't know, you gotta try it on.
I actually like this.
I do.
Come here.
Do you protection?
Yeah. I like the door.
What got you spooked? First time you seen running water?
Trust my gut. I just think we're better off not being here. Go upstairs and get Paul and Matt on.
Yeah, and try not to join in.
Well, what the fuck is your problem?
And the rest of you come with me.
Somebody want to tell me what the hate blew up your butt?
Looks like you have one heck of a flat out there.
You're telling me? We ran over an elephant head.
Well, I don't know about elephants out this way, but I'm sure you folks could use some help.
See? I told you God wouldn't leave us here. He sent an angel to help us.
Sweet Jesus, I'm gonna throw up.
I'm sorry about that. I'm a teacher and I work with these troubled teens.
Well, I'm no angel. My name is Dylan, and this here is my...
boyfriend.
Brother, Jace.
Score.
Excuse me?
Wait, you came out of the same mother as him?
Half-brother. And who are you?
He's just a bus driver. Listen, you mentioned something about helping us. Do you have a phone or maybe a phone number?
Seriously, I'm gonna throw up on this floor right here.
Don't ruin this for me.
Well, I'm sure you've all noticed that cell phones don't work around these parts. We're fixing up the old house, hoping to sell it, but honestly, I think the cell phone thing is gonna hurt us. Anyway, I have a big SUV right out front, and we can take you up to Carlisle. It'll be like 15 minutes tops.
Maybe you can drive slow.
Is this all of you?
There's two more upstairs.
I'm sure they'll be right down.
Well, Jace can go take care of it. Why don't we just go wait out front?
We'll wait here.
Of course. Mr. Watson!
Oh,
yeah, I needed a B. Oh, shut up. I want to finish. Oh.
Occupied!
Get your shit and get out.
Oh, you driving? Shotgun.
Yeah, you may want to get some hand sanitizer and use it everywhere, bro.
Are you a safe driver, ma'am? I have an egg.
You're gonna walk to the SUV and go.
That's the plan.
Hey, nice ride. Practical.
It's nothing.
Are you kidding me? Listen, honey, I did construction in college. You know how many times we blew up? Effing zero!
Deal with unconscious.
So is there a reason we ran back into the house? If we're dealing with crazy serial killers, wouldn't it make more sense to run into the woods or something?
You're right. If we were all healthy and knew what we were doing.
Right. Okay. I see your point. Yeah, they're brother and sister. They probably got like 9-headed babies or something, right?
Look, I don't know what's going on here, but I really don't think they're killers.
Really? What were they trying to do to Gooch?
Yeah, did the dude just see a mosquito on him and go into overkill mode or something?
Something they were looking for upstairs. Look, Paul, why don't you run up and see what it is they were looking for?
What, are we taking orders from the bus driver now?
Yes. And if the rest of you want to live, you'll do the same. If Dylan is smart, she'll take care of the fire out back first. Then circle back around here to deal with us. That gives us maybe 5 or 10 minutes to get ready.
Get ready for what?
What are we making, a cake?
You can help me find something to fight with if you want to be useful.
Oh, weapons, yeah. Yeah, that makes sense.
Ideas?
My stepdad used to keep his weed in one of these things.
What the hell is that stuff?
It's meth.
They're goddamn drug dealers.
This is the Scream.
What is that? An indie band?
This is stuff of legend. It's the best meth, best anything on the planet. These just aren't drug dealers. They are the drug dealers.
Great. We're in an episode of Breaking Bad.
These original cookers, they all got dead except for one.
Now the remaining cook is training a new crew. That explains the fireball. You gonna be all right, son?
Hey, just keep the box locked, okay?
All right. So this is the situation as I see it. We got something they want. We trade that for a ride and our lives. And we can all go home and forget all this ever happened.
They're just gonna let us go?
If we're up to the big idiot, no. But it's not up to him. Dylan, or whatever her real name is, she's in charge. She's not dumb.
A woman meth maker. You see what feminism leads to?
So we take our chances. We do everything we can to avoid a fight.
What if we can't avoid one?
Make damn sure we don't lose. At least they're predictable. Ready? Let's go.
All right, I'm just gonna say it. He's fucking sexy as hell. Since when did the school district start hiring Rambo? I mean, he's a bus driver.
I'm worried about my egg.
Way to keep things in perspective, Caden.
Your heartbeat. Let's go. There you go.
What are you talking about?
When you're scared, you listen to your heartbeat. One. If you can hear it, it means you're still alive. And two. We'll get to two later. Thank you.
I could have just come in firing.
I don't think so. Couldn't be sure what we found up there.
You don't think I can cook more?
I don't know. How long does it take to replace a burnt-out meth lab?
You know, I'm about at the end of my patience.
Oh, finally some common ground. You give us wheels and your word this is over, get the boxes.
I send my men in. I collect the merchandise, and then we talk terms.
When I'm behind the wheel.
Oh, so now I'm not trustworthy?
Ah, my fucking leg!
This isn't a goddamn standoff! How's this for trustworthy? If it's all there, I kill you quick. Get it!
What? You gonna call the cops?
Bring brains.
Upstairs. Move!
You're not supposed to move an injured man! I'm in shock!
Ah! You want me to slap you again, Mr. Gooch?
I woke up in a Steven Seagal movie.
Cigar.
Insurance. Better they smoked him than we take him to the hospital. Have to answer questions.
You're playing goddamn cover girl in here. They're fucking high while I'm getting shot at, and Dean and Ronan are fucking dead!
They're a waste, like I said. Somebody has to make sure the operation stays intact.
Dig.
I dig.
Survive,
We need to stay calm.
Yo, how the fuck did you do that?
Hey! Language! You want my history or do you want to live?
I vote live.
All right. Two are dead for sure. And the others are at least slowed down. Their goal is going to be in killing us and getting their product back.
So we go out the back door.
There's no back door down there, Mr. Gooch.
We're not going to get this entire group down and out the front door before they have men on it.
So we cut the wounded and the weak? Or the youngest and the weirdest?
We're not leaving anyone behind.
So we're dead.
Actually, we're about 400 feet from getting out of here alive.
You're our free safety. You don't watch football. Jeez. You know which end the bullets come out of the gun? Huh?
Yeah, I got it.
Okay, great. Don't let them get past you.
Do I know which end the bullets come out of? Bitch! I ain't stupid! I did 2 semesters of English at Trenton State!
No time to argue. I don't even
want to
think about what you were doing on this bed. That's why you don't have a date to prom.
Mrs. Smythe, there's one more right there.
All right,
cover your eyes.
Two semesters of English.
Teacher and go. Paul, shut the front door, will you?
Kids, get in the back. Hold it.
Keep him safe.
Where are the men? Let's get him over.
God damn! Born identity.
We have 2 minutes before they're back. Give me a minute. If I'm not finished with them yet.
I admire your sacrifice.
And to think, 5 minutes ago I was thinking about quitting.
Still time.
And turn the other cheek so you can scar that one too. I'm a man with revenge on his mind. Get rid of the gun.
Let go of the boy.
You to go. I don't even know how to drive a truck. I think it's stuck in reverse.
Move. Move. Get down. Get down.
Fire! The tire.
Got something you might want to see.
Maybe they have a first aid kit in here. Fuck, Gooch! What were you thinking? What did you expect from gun-toting meth-addicted lunatics?
You're gonna be able to hold it together?
Yeah, sure. I don't want to jinx it or nothing, but I mean, the rough stuff is over, right?
Mr. Gooch, whoa!
Can you boys hear me?
We're here.
Well, you answered. Such nice manners.
My daddy used to take me camping. And before we leave, he'd always make us do a dummy check.
Do you know what that is, bus driver?
Put the kid on.
Go on. Say hi, honey.
I'm sorry, Mr. Smythe.
We got a problem.
Let's go. I was thinking about you.
That's when you checked and made sure you didn't leave anything behind. Like a dump.
What do you want?
You come back with my lock boxes and my truck. You have 10 minutes to think it over.
Jesus.
Smythe? I'm sorry.
For what?
You told me to get everyone in the truck and I couldn't even do that.
It's not your
fault. It is. There was so much blood and I didn't even get a head count. It wasn't until we're moving that I realized that Paul was...
You listened to your heartbeat for two reasons. Remember the first one?
To remember you're still alive.
Second reason. Remember that every battle begins and ends in here. I'm not out of this yet. You need to win the battle in here. You got people counting on you to have your shit together. Are you good?
I'm good.
All right. I need your shirt.
Wait, what?
We're not going back there, are we? All I'm saying is this. We saved 4 out of the 5 kids. You and me. We got 80%. That's a B. They're gonna be waiting for us. And they got guns. Unless that weird kid has a bazooka in his egg, it's a death sentence. Come on, Smythe! I only got 3 payments left on my Corvette!
I lost the team once. It's a hurt you keep with you a long time, Gooch. You think you can live with that?
Definitely. All right.
Take Mr. Gooch and head east as fast as you can hoof it. The second you get cell signal, you call the police. Am I clear?
You going back there?
You step on my bus. You're my responsibility. Every last one of you. I don't leave a man behind.
I'm going with you.
You got a team that needs you right here. The best way you can help me is by keeping them safe and getting a hold of the police. You got me?
It's not like you were a supermodel before all this.
This isn't how you said this would go. In the way all of them are coming back.
Don't need them. Whoever comes back, we kill them, take the product, and get the fuck out of Dodge.
You know, I've been thinking about something.
Yeah?
My first thought was, we're only halfway done with the bank. And I didn't sweat my balls off in that garage to walk away with half. But then I figured, hey, so many men did. Even with half the product, our sheriffs can work out to be more than they were before. Blessing in disguise, you know.
That's one way to look at it, I guess.
The guy that did all that killing, it's probably him that's gonna be driving that truck here. Well, my daddy had a saying, when the devil's at your door, you don't invite him in.
You shot your father.
9 times. But that don't make him wrong. I say we give him back the kid and we get out of here.
That man is broken and bleeding. We have him outnumbered and outgunned. We have a goddamn hostage. You want something to be scared of, Jason? He's not a machine. He's not the devil. He's a goddamn bus driver.
Touch the kid. We're coming.
But Mr. Smythe, they're gonna kill you.
You're probably right. They are gonna kill me. But now they pissed me off. So I'm gonna kill as many of those fuckers as I can first.
Don't tell anybody he said the F word. Come on. I don't want him to lose his job, I'm just saying.
Get the product first, and then we bury him. But this one's ears in his pocket. Frisco, where's my shit?
It's in the truck. Some in front, some in back.
You're gonna keep playing games right up to the very end, aren't you?
Keeps it exciting.
Get the meth.
The boy.
He's high as a kite. Say what you want about me, bus driver, but I make one good product.
Jammed up with something.
Well, can you open it?
Yeah.
The fuck are you, a chicken?
Well?
It's all here.
down!
If I don't take care of the egg, I'm gonna fail the class.
Kid, you don't give up. I admire that. But it's not just you and the egg anymore. Look. That's your squad, Caden. We all gotta make sacrifices for our squad.
I'm part of the squad?
I hope the kids do battle together. It's a bond that lasts forever.
I've never failed a class in my life.
I can make a long speech about the needs of the many versus the needs of the few, but I frankly don't have the time. So how about this? If your teacher, he doesn't give you an A on this project, I'll punch him in his throat.
Thank you.
bus driver. I ain't dead yet. Got any more tricks? You got a grenade hiding in your pockets? I ain't playing around anymore. Come on. Die standing, die in the ground. Makes no difference to me.
And stay dead, you goddamn Freddy Krueger-looking motherfucker!
Gooch?
Jesus! Oh, my God! I leave you for 2 minutes, and you all go to shit!
But how?
Me and Holden, we could flag him down. He didn't want to take me back here, so me and Holden helped him in here. Mostly Holden. This I can drive.
Have you seen Paul or Dylan?
What? No, thank you? I just risked my life here, pal. I'm a motherfucking hero. After all this shit, you and me are gonna be famous. We're gonna go on Nancy Grace, and afterwards, I'm gonna bang that bitch until her butthole whistles.
Dylan went off with Paul. Have you seen them?
They're getting blood on my shirt. No, I drove in here, I didn't see anything. You mean he wasn't the last one? There's more to do? What the shit, Smythe? What were you doing while I was saving your ass?
The bus. They're gonna take the bus. It's the only thing with an engine. You gotta drive.
I gotta drive? I didn't even have to come back here. How about a thank you, Gooch?
Leave me the fuck alone!
You smoked some of my stuff, so I know you think you're invincible. But I want you to feel this. Do you feel it? Ah! Do you feel it? This is real. That hole in your hand is real. The only reason why you're alive right now is because I might need something to trade. But I probably won't. So keep your mouth shut or I'll end you!
Hey, bitch! And another fucking move or I'll blow your head off! Where the hell did you get these guns from? Singapore?
Fucking shit! Fuck!
Come out and die like a fucking man!
Oh, fuck you, Vic!
Gooch!
What?
these days, that big mouth of yours, it's gonna get you killed.
Let me ask you a question. My role was on the bus. What's your name?
It's Paul.
Paul? Listen, Paul. I'm not gonna sugarcoat it, okay? You fucked up real bad. But I did too. And it wasn't my idea to come back and get you. But I'll tell you what. If you don't kick yourself so hard about this whole fucking thing, I'll do the same. Deal?
Deal. What was it, you? Whose decision was it?
To come back for your meth-smoking butt? That would be the bus driver.
Assaulted by teenagers, thrown out of a window, got shot twice, and drove a German homo car through a garage door, window. How do I feel? This is the greatest day of my life. Hey, you wouldn't happen to have Nancy Grace's phone number, would you?
This from a buddy of mine today down at the Pentagon. You could have saved us a lot of running around if you'd been more forthcoming about your background. All right. You only have the right to remain silent if I arrest you. We'll wait for the suits in the morning. You know all those bodies this afternoon? The story would have been a lot more plausible if you just told us who you were.
I told you who I was. I'm the bus driver.
all that money we spent on training and you wind up here. I don't think the Pentagon would enjoy seeing what's become of you.
I don't think the Pentagon has a say in anything I do anymore, General.
Very formal. All right, we can use titles if you like. Colonel.
Not anymore.
Just because you haven't spent any of your pension checks doesn't mean you're not still one of us, Joe. It's a blood thing.
I have a trip I need to take.
I've got a better one for you. More exotic than here. Wherever here is, you interested?
Not even a little. Look, I really need to get going.
All right, then. All right. All right.
I'm not coming back, sir. I like being a bus driver. It's a quiet life.
Call me when you get tired of the quiet.
Who was that guy? Captain Crunch?
Something like that.
Come on, let's go pick up the retard squad.
Thank you.